The days of hanging out in nightclubs, meeting new people and dancing are on hold. But for the iconic 18th Street Lounge, those days are gone for good.
The legacy of 18th Street Lounge was that it was a home for musicians and DJs to be able to express themselves creatively, perform.
Thomas Blondet is former DJ at ESL. Is it end of an era?
It's definitely an end of an era because now a lot of the musicians in DC and DJs don't have a home to play, you know, their music that we can't play anywhere else. You know, we have that creative freedom there.
The ESL Club, as the 18th Street Lounge was called, was one of the leaders of the Washington night scene. But its owners fear that its end has come.
Any other way, when you have 6 feet apart, people wearing masks, no communication with the bartenders, 6 feet apart, no entertainment and no dancing, what is the point of being in a nightclub? There's absolutely zero point.
Farid Nouri is the co-founder and owner of the 18th Street Lounge. After 25 years of work, the bar's jubilee would have been celebrated in October, but no longer. ESL is institution, but we will try again with launch on other way to express yourself?
Yes, you know, someone said institutions don't die, they evolve. It's time for us to evolve, and the intersection of time is pretty appropriate if you ask me. We just hit our 25th anniversary, the pandemic hit, and our lease ran out. So it's an opportunity to leave on a high note.
The hope is that this club, that has been a gathering place for musicians, jet sets, music producers, DJs, a place for fashion shows, will return to Washington in some other form, in newfound glory. Jane Bojagievski, VOA News, Washington.